Need to know how to quickly navigate your PowerPoint presentations? Want to give your audience a sneak peek at your topics and how they all fit together? If the answer is yes, you need to add a PowerPoint table of contents to your next slide deck. A table of contents is a hub for your presentation. It lists every slide that you'll be sharing in clear, easy-to-read style. In this screencast, I'm going to show you how to quickly make a great table of contents in PowerPoint. When you think of how to insert a table of contents, your first thought should be to turn to premium templates. A premium design offers you unmatched style and creative control. The best place to source these premium templates is Envato Elements. Elements is an all-you-can-download resource with thousands of amazing PPT table of contents options. Along with PowerPoint templates, you'll also have access to stock photos, fonts, audio, and more. All of these assets can be used to bring your table of contents PPT to life. Browse your options and join Envato Elements now. For this tutorial, we'll be working in the Agio PowerPoint template from Elements. I have it downloaded here and it's opened up in PowerPoint. Now, before we begin, let's think about where to place our PowerPoint table of contents. I like to put these on the second slide in my deck. The first one should generally be reserved for your title or cover slide. But before you dive into other topics, it makes sense to place your table of contents very early in the deck. The slide here has some basic text boxes and shape designs on it with plenty of open space. It's a good choice for our table of contents PPT. Now, you really have two ways to build a table of contents. You can simply list off the content topics in a static list. Or, better yet, you can make an interactive table of contents. Let's go interactive here. To get started, let's say that I want to link to slide 3 in the PowerPoint. Clicking on it here, you'll see that this is an About Us slide. Jumping back to our table of contents, I'm going to click into the text box here. Instead of typing the name of the other slide, I want to actually link to it. That way, when someone clicks on the item in the table of contents, PowerPoint will actually take them to that particular slide. To add the link, go to the Insert tab on PowerPoint's ribbon, as you're seeing me do here. In the middle, there's this link button, and you can go ahead and click there to open it up. Here, you have a few options. First up, you'll want to give your link a name. In this box here, put the text that you want to display. Here, we'll use About Us. Then, you'll need to link to the specific slide. Click on this document here, and you'll see a list of options. Your best bet is to click on Slide Titles and choose the third slide from the list. Once you're done, click OK. PowerPoint will add your first table of contents item. From here, it functions just like any other string of text. For example, I can highlight it here and come up to the Home tab on the ribbon. Then, I can change the font color by going into this dropdown. PowerPoint may default to a color that's hard to read, so it pays to make this adjustment. While I still have text selected, I can also change the font style or add effects like bold by clicking on these buttons here. As you can see, this is how to insert a table of contents in PowerPoint quickly. Don't see a font that you want to use? Let's revisit the powerful Envato Elements offer. As a member, you also have access to a vast library of custom fonts. These work great in PowerPoint, and they help you style your table of contents in incredible ways. Check out the library and download your favorites today. Back on the slide here, you can continue building out your table of contents by repeating the steps of adding links to additional slides. Flashing forward here, you'll see that I've populated the rest of my table of contents PPT. From here, I can make a few more style changes to get the layout just right. For example, some of the items listed like these team intros are subsets of the category immediately above them, Meet the Team. I'll make Meet the Team bold here so that I can signify how these slides fit together. And I can also indent the subcategories below. To do that, I'll place my cursor right in front of one of these lines. Then, I'll hit the Tab key on my keyboard once. Watch as PowerPoint indents the link text. Flashing forward again, you'll see how quickly a PowerPoint table of contents can come together. I'll preview it in slideshow mode here. Watch how PowerPoint jumps to the link slides whenever I click on a line of text. As you can see, it's easy to learn how to insert a table of contents in PowerPoint. These are stylish, interactive tools that help you outline, explain, and navigate your slide decks. Any PowerPoint can benefit from them. Start adding a table of contents to all of your presentations. This really helps you make a powerful impression and set the stage for your audience. And don't forget, Envato Elements is your best resource for stunning templates just like these. Browse the library of thousands of custom templates and pick out your favorites. Join today and start using them for your next PPT deck. Before you go, don't forget to like this video. Plus, be sure to subscribe to our Envato Tuts Plus YouTube channel. There, you're going to find more helpful tutorials just like this one. Plus, you'll see courses, content roundups, and so much more. I'm Andrew Childress for Envato Tuts Plus, and thanks again for joining me.